President Rodrigo Duterte says he doesn't see anyone deserving to be a successor, but he may publicly name some choices soon. In an interview with religious leader Apollo Quiboloy Tuesday, June 8, Duterte says he will stay neutral for now but will name some of his choices when the time comes. Duterte also says the presidency takes more than just what one shows today. He also claims that he again discouraged his eldest daughter, Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte, from running for president during their conversation on Monday, June 7. He describes the presidency to his daughter as a thankless job she can get nothing out of, except for the sense of fulfillment that you did something for your fellow man. Sara is being pushed as a presidential bet largely by Duterte supporters, but she has yet to announce her decision. In the same interview, Duterte claims he is not sold on the call of his political party members to run for vice president in 2022, as he is planning to retire after his presidency. Quiboloy, who supported Duterte's presidential bid in 2016, tries to convince him to reconsider. President Rodrigo Duterte tells Senator Manny Pacquiao to study foreign policy first before commenting on the government's response to Chinese aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Duterte makes a statement Tuesday, June 8, in an interview with religious leader Apollo Quiboloy. On May 3, Pacquiao said he finds the president's response to the swarming of Chinese ships in the West Philippine Sea as lacking. Duterte's reaction to Pacquiao, although late, gives a clue as to where the boxer-turned-lawmaker stands in his eyes. In a statement Wednesday, June 9, Pacquiao stands by his assessment of Duterte's defeatist stance over the West Philippine Sea. He says his assessment reflects the sentiment of the majority of Filipinos to stand strong in protecting the country's sovereign rights. Pacquiao adds, while he respects Duterte's opinion, he also, quote, humbly disagrees with the president on foreign policy. The senator also says he is a Filipino that is, quote, voicing out what needs to be said in defense of what has been adjudicated as rightfully ours. Filipino fishermen of sunken fishing boat Gem Ver have yet to receive the aid promised to them after their near-death experience. It's been 2 years since on June 9, 2019, when the Philippine fishing boat Gem Ver was sunk and abandoned by a Chinese vessel in the West Philippine Sea. Gem Ver owner Fed De La Torre and the boat's former captain Junel Insigne tell Rappler the compensation promised by the Duterte government and China are more urgent due to the pandemic. The health crisis hampered their ability to work while trying to recover from the economic impact of the sunk fishing boat. De La Torre says there were several failed attempts to reach out to the government in the past, but she remains hopeful the crew will receive compensation. Recent negotiations between Philippine and Chinese officials revived the issue, with discussions covering 12 million pesos in civil and moral damages for Gem Ver's 22 fishermen and its owners. De La Torre adds the money they will receive will cover losses from the months they have been unable to work. There are also 2 million pesos in loans they are still paying off for Gem Ver's repairs. The former captain, meanwhile, says he will use his share to get his family back on its feet after being unable to find work in 2020. He hopes to use the money to pay loans and, together with his wife, put up a small store that sells fishing goods. The Central Visayas Police files a motion for reconsideration for the recently dismissed complaints against LUMA teachers and students in Cebu arrested on February 15 for allegedly training child warriors. Among those arrested is Chad Book, an activist and volunteer teacher. The regional police on Tuesday, June 8, says the complaints are refiled with the Davao del Norte provincial prosecutor by their anti-kidnapping group.
To clarify po, what cases were refiled? What are we talking about when we say cases were refiled?
We have filed at least 3 cases and we are still planning for other cases.
On May 5, the Davao del Norte fiscal initially dismissed the complaints for insufficiency of evidence, lack of probable cause, and being outside the territorial jurisdiction.
According to the resolutions of the fiscal, crimes were committed. But according to the resolutions, they have no jurisdiction. But during OMR, we stressed that Davao del Norte has jurisdictions.
The complaints included serious illegal detention, kidnapping, and child abuse. Globe Studios announces on Monday, June 7, a 3-episode Gaya sa Pelikula special to be released in time for Pride Month. Gaya sa Pelikula special, ang pagbawi ng ating kwento is set to air on June 11, 18, and 25 at 8 p.m. via Globe Studios' YouTube channel. Based on the trailer, the special takes fans behind the scenes from the conceptualization to the filming of the series. The show, written by Juan Miguel Severo and directed by J.P. Habak, tells the story of two college students, Carl and Vlad, who deal with family issues and figure out their identities as they find themselves falling for each other. It stars Paulo Pangilinan and Ian Pangilinan as Carl and Vlad, respectively. Gaya sa Pelikula started streaming in September 2020 and was among the first Filipino boys love series that were released at the height of the lockdown. The Philippines sees a sharp rise in interest in BL series following the success of Thai show Together the Series in the country.